So here's a little bit of hip conditioning for you. We're gonna come onto our hands and knees. Spread your fingers nice and wide. Untuck your toes. Press the tops of your feet into the mat. Wrist, elbow, shoulders stack one on top of the other. Let's just start by dropping our rib cage down to the floor and then lifting our mid back up. Drop down, lift up. We're breathing. Send your hips to the left, head to the right. Opposite way, we just sway from side to side. Feel that movement in your wrists and your shoulders as well. And then from here, hips circle back, in around, in the front. Nice big circles, relax your head and neck, soften your face. Just flow with your circles. Keep that breath moving. You can close your eyes and just feel around. Feel how your body's feeling. Tune in. Switch directions. If you have any tension, any stress, any blockages anywhere, this is the time to kind of check in, tune in, listen to our bodies communicate to us. And then from here, I let my hips come to one side, circle back, other side. So I'm like drawing these half circles. Good, pause in the center, hands and knees. Again, drop the rib cage down, lift it up, down and up, down and up. Pause in the middle, hold strong here. Ground down in your right knee, left knee comes up, draws a nice big circle. Ooh, I hear some pops already. Circle through. Keep your core nice and strong. Keep the weight equally distributed in between both hands. Draw a nice big circle with that knee. Up and around. And switch directions, up. We're gonna do our second side now. Take your right knee, draw a nice big circle up and around. Keep your mid body aligned, weight equally distributed in between both hands. Use your glute to lift and circle around, just like we're exploring the perimeter of our hip. Playing with our own range of motion. Getting really curious. Pause in the center. Now from here, just release that low back. Come down into child's pose. And then we're just gonna rock forward, let the hips dip down, push it back. Rocking back and forth. At any point, especially if you feel it in the wrist, sit back, shake those wrists out, round those wrists out, get back into it. Now from here, take your left knee, lift, and bring it down. And lift, and down, nice and strong. Up, and down. Keep your core strong. Don't drop the belly button, don't drop the ribcage down to the floor. Keep the spine neutral. Give it that squeeze at the top. Sometimes here we drop the ribcage just so we can get higher. No, we want to keep our alignment, lift how high, as high as we can while maintaining that alignment. Now from here, take your right leg, reach it back. Knee up, kick back. And up and back. And up and back. Get a good pace going, back and up and back. Lift it up, hold here, nice and strong. Kick the foot out, reach it back and out and back. floor strong and back. Reach it out, swing it back, swing it up, swing it back. Reach it straight back, curl the heel in, extend it out and in and out. And in, maintain your neutral spine. And then we tap, four arms down and lift. Tap and lift. Tap and lift. And pull, squeeze, squeeze at the top. Shoulders stay in line with the elbows. Keep your face soft. Bring it in. Push it back. Forehead down. Nice big breath. Shake it out. We come back. Second side. Start with lifting it to the side. Lift the knee up. Foot comes up too. And up. From here, we kick it straight back. Lift, kick. Lift, kick. Find the rhythm, boom. Find your own rhythm with your breath, with your movement. Hold it up, out, and in, and out. Oh, feel that strength. Oh, my muscles are talking to me. Reach it out. Swing it back. Whoa. Swing it forward, and back, and forward. Reach it back. Tap it down, down on your forearm, and lift, down, and tap, sorry, lift, squeeze, and squeeze. Knee in, push it back. Wrap your arms down around your feet, let your shoulders roll forward. Extend your arms out. We come back. In, round your back when we pull it in. Lift, keep your rib cage pulling up. Lift as high as you can. In, up. Give it that squeeze at the top. Don't drop your rib cage, just to lift it higher. We really want to avoid that. Give it that squeeze. Give it that squeeze. Hold your knee up to hip height. Flatten your foot. Pulse, pulse, pulse. Oh, yeah. Punch, punch. Hold. Extend. Keep your foot flexed. Curl it in and out and in and out and in and out and in and out. Good. Tuck the right toes under. And lift and tap. Good. Bring it down. Second side in, up. Curl, reach, squeeze. Good, flat foot, pulse. Ooh. Ooh. Extend, curl it in. Extend it out. Curl it in. Tuck your left toes under. Let's lift. And tap. And lift. Good. Bring your feet down. Bring your knees down. Let's come back into our circles. Switch directions. Pause in the center. Lift your right leg up, curl the heel in. Right hand reaches back, grabs that foot, press your foot into the hand. Let's hold your planted hand, shoulder right on top of the wrist. Whew, second side. Lift, curl, grab. Good, now from here, tuck the toes under. Let's just hover our knees up off the mat. From here, give them a little bounce. Good finisher, right? I'm gonna sit through, hip up. Sit through. Good, from here, I hold, look. Hip down, hip up. Down and up, down and up. Second side. Down and up. Come back to center, hold, knees bounce. Let them open, in, out, in. Right to the end. And that's it. Take a few breaths. A little bit of hip conditioning for you.